You're listening to the Grace Watcher Broadcasting Network, and this is Apostle Paul E. Jones, and I am a Native American preacher, and I preach to the called, and to the chosen, and to the faithful. And today, our discussion, being a Gnostic in a hostile world. Stay back and enjoy. This is going to be a shocking, unnerving lesson in spirituality. This little light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. I said that this little light of mine, I said that I'm gonna let it shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. Well, I hide it under a bushel, no, and I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no, and I'm gonna let it shine. I said it, hide it under a bushel, no, and I'm gonna let it shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. This little light of mine, I say that I'm gonna let it shine. I say that this little light of mine, that I'm gonna let it shine. I say that this little light of mine, I say that I'm gonna let it shine. That each and every day, that in my life, to let the light shine. That each and every day, that in my life, to let the light shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. I'm gonna let it shine. The hallelujah, got to 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 let it shine. When I was a little child and I went to church, every once in a while in youth class, we would sing, "This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine." Now it's 50 years later. I'm still singing that song, but it's just not like it was way back then. Because I got a fresher knowledge and wisdom and understanding about that light. And when you begin to get the Gnostic of ideas, and you start really seeing the truth that's around you in this world that we're living in, you really do begin to see what the light is all about. That true light that's been around since the beginning of time. This little light of mine, and I'm going to let it shine. Yeah, I said that this little light of mine, I said that I'm going to let it shine. I said that this little light of mine, I said that I'm going to let it shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. I said I won't let the devil blow it out, and I'm going to let it shine. And let me tell you now, I won't let the devil blow it out, and I'm going to let it shine. I said now I won't let the devil blow it out, and I'm going to let it shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. let me tell you never this little light of mine. That I know you that you're not going to let it shine. I said that this little light of mine. And I'm gonna let it shine. Then let me tell you that this little light of mine. And I'm gonna let it shine every day and in my life. To let the light shine. And each and every day and in my life. To let the light shine. I said that each and every day and in my life. To let the light shine. I've got to let it shine. Hallelujah. 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 I've got to let it shine. So what are we talking about today? Being a Gnostic in a hostile world. As I said earlier, it's going to be explosive. It's going to be mind-altering. It may get confusing. But if you'll keep listening, you'll wake up to the lies and the deceptions that has been thrown at you for many, many times. But it's time to bust that bubble. It's time to reach down into that brain and pull out all of that confusion and doubt and unbelief and just put in a little truth right in there. It's time to wake up, people. It's time to come to the truth. It's time, as we used to say, shake off those heavy bands. And let's get it digging deeper into some truth. Oh, yeah. Just think about it. If I'd have known today, back 50 years ago, as a 7-year-old child, oh, I wish I'd have known what I know today back then. Maybe I wouldn't have to go through a lot of the struggles and the insecurities and the confusions and all the stuff that we had to go through. But it makes me what I am today. So what is a Gnostic? Well, Gnostics have been around for thousands of years, if not millions of years. We can see beyond the bullshit that's all in the world. We can look beyond the deceptions and the lies and the twistings of truth, and we begin to see what's really going on behind the scene. A Gnostic comes to the realization that there is more than what you see with a natural eye. There's more going on in this world than what you've been told. And just when you think you've got the truth, something knocks you off your reality of confusion and puts you right back down to the floor again. One thing about being a Gnostic, just when I think I know it, there's more I need to learn. When I was going to church as a young person, I was told, this is the way the world is. You are a sinner. You're on the way to hell. And now come to our church and receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. And wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, you are saved. And we used to get up every Sunday morning and sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Yes, we did. nothing but the blood of Jesus. But then one day, I got slapped in the face and I fell on the floor because I said, this stuff just don't seem right. So I started heading out to the library while I was going to seminary. Back in 1984, between 84 and 89, I was in cemetery. And somatically, I was being programmed to believe what the seminary taught. You know, stuff like God loves everybody and God has a plan for you and God wants to save everyone. And but you've got to believe what we as the people in the church are telling you to believe. And every time they came up with an ideology and a principle, a dogmatic truth, you had to believe it. And we as ministers, we were trained to believe in certain things. Certain doctrinal truths. And not only did we have to believe it, but we had to spread these truths to everybody else like a virus. Oops. Like we're spreading a virus now. A contagious virus. And unless, you know, you get tested to find out if you got it or not, you don't know if you have it or not. And whether you have this virus or you don't have this virus, you need to get tested. And not only get tested, but now you need to get a vaccine. And if you don't get the vaccine, you may spread the virus. And it gets deeper than that. Now you got to wear a mask. Whether you have the virus or not, you got to wear a mask. And you got to stay 6 feet from each other. Why are you wearing a mask? Because you're told to shut up. Just accept what's being told to you. Accept what's being said to you. Just shut up. Put your mask on. Go get tested. Get this vaccine. You see, this thing is more deeper than people are coming to grasp. Because once you wake up to the lies and to the deception, and to the chaos that's all around you, and you find out everything that you've been told in the past and the present and the future, it's all bullshit. Now you're understanding why you're being told staying 6 feet from each other, wearing a mask, that you are contagious, and what you have could spread to somebody else. This hideous disease that they're saying that's happening to everybody, that it'll spread to everybody else, and you will infect everybody with what you know. Because when you wake up to the truth, you want to tell other people about it. But no, you got to put on a mask and shut your mouth up, accept what's being told to you, despite everything around you is lies and deception, and it's nothing but chaos over and over and over and over and over. And I'm going to share some truths with you today. You can accept it, or you could go back into your matrix of the red pill or the blue pill. And still live in your little bubble that this matrix, this simulation, this illusion has put you into. Just go back in your bubble. Go back into your four walls. Go back into your confusion. But if you have an inkling that maybe there's something beyond those four walls that you're living in. You're having a inkling that maybe there's something going on outside that bubble. Then hang in there and listen to me for a while. Because I'm going to give you a tidbit of some truths to boggle your brain, maybe twist some of those nerves, maybe giving you some hope beyond this illusion that we've been living in. I remember when the movie The Matrix came out many years ago. And it was told to me, if you'll watch that movie at least four times, you'll get some truth out of it. So I watched it once, and I watched it twice, and I watched it three times. But the fourth time, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, I started seeing the world differently. And coming from a religious fanatical ideology, I really started seeing what's going on in this world. There are two gods that are in this world. One God thinks he is God, and the other God knows he is God. And the one that thinks he is God, your Bible calls the God of this world. But even beyond the one who thinks he is God, there is a true God. And so now, here we come down into this little planet we call Earth. There is the true God, and then there's the God of this world. Your Bible says the God of this world has blinded the minds of the people. Your Bible says the God of this world has deceived the whole world. But we want to walk around and we're claiming that we know who the true God is. But see, in our simplicity minds, and the way we've been raised, and the traditions that we have been handed down for years and years, we refuse to bust that bubble to see beyond that maybe the God we've been worshiping, maybe it is the God of this world and not the God of this universe. Because things have been twisted, and things have been rearranged. Now people are waking up and they're saying, well, wait a minute. You're saying that there's two gods, one is real, and the one thinks he is God, that most people are worshiping that God of the world instead of the God of the universe. And guess what? Yep. So, preacher, how am I supposed to figure out who the God of the universe is and who the God of the world is? Hang in now. This is where gnosis comes from. Yeah, that's a Greek word, and it means wisdom. You know, we need knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Those three trinities can help you to see beyond this world and bypass this God of the world and look for the God of the universe. But in order to bypass the God of this world and see the God of the universe, you need to know the difference between the God of this world and the God of this universe. This is why being a Gnostic is hostility to the world. Because once you wake up to the lies and the deceptions that you have been quote unquote programmed with, you know, television, it's called programming. Tonight's programming is going to be this show, that show, this other show. Which channel are you going to watch? Is it going to be ABC, CBS, NBC? Is it going to be CNN? Is it going to be Fox News? Is it going to be MSNBC? Is it going to be BBC? Whatever. It's all programming to foster your belief system. It's the same thing in the political world. It's programming. Your religious world, it's programming. Your psychological world, it's programming. Your educational system, it's programming. Everything around you is programming for you to believe in a set of values, morals, and beliefs. And so, the God of this world has done pretty good in fashioning this system of programming. And many of us have accepted this system of programming. But even cultic experts will tell you that sometimes you have to reprogram your brain to get out of this illusionary system. So now religion has to come into the equation. And through religion, it's trying to pull you out of the programming. But the God of this world knew that. So now the God of this world's twist is the religious system that are around you to pull you out of religion back into its programming format. That's why the stuff that I'm talking about, it's very deep. And unless you pull past the bullshit that has been programmed into you, you're going to think that religion and politics and the psychological systems of the world is there to really to help you. In fact, there's a word that's thrown around a lot. L-O-V-E. Well, you know, your politician, they love you. Your religious leaders, they love you. Your psychological leaders, they love you. The news, they love you. Everybody, it's just kumbaya. We all love you. And you wake up one day and you find out, well, if you love me, why are you keeping me in bondage? Why are you telling me that I have to conform to everything that's around? See, you're getting it. You're waking up. You're waking up to the programming. You're waking up to the lies and the deceptions and all the chaos that's around you. And now that you try to pull out of this manifestation of the God of this world, now the God of this world and his minions, and he's got minions, are trying to pull you back into their system. And you keep fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting to pull yourself out of the system. And now you're in what is called duality. It all started out at the beginning. In your Bible, Adam and Eve is on the scene. God comes along and he tells Adam and Eve, don't eat of the tree of what? The knowledge of good and evil. God tells Adam and Eve, when you eat of that tree, you're gonna die. And now here comes the serpent prancing along. And he tells Eve, if you eat of that tree, you're not gonna die, sweetie. You're gonna become like God. You're gonna know the knowledge of good and evil. And Eve says, honey, give me that tree. Give me that fruit. And she started gobbling up that thing. She started eating that thing. And the next thing you know, your Bible says her eyes were open. She looks over at her husband, Adam, says, Adam, come on over here, honey. You got to eat this tree. It is delicious. It is out of this world. It'll give you the knowledge of good and evil. And Adam says, give me that thing. He eats it. And then in the cool of the day, here comes God walking down the garden in the cool of the day. And he says, Adam, where are you? And Adam says, I hid. And God says, why did you hide? And Adam says, I was afraid. God says, what are you afraid of? I'm naked. My wife's naked. So we're sowing fig leaves. My goodness. And as you deep down into the rabbit hole of this incident that all the major religions talk about, how the first man and the first woman messed up everything that's in this world, and now we're put right in the middle of a war called the world of duality, good and evil. You know, even your prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel said that there will come a time that they will say, everything that you say that's good, they're going to call evil. And everything that's called evil, they're going to call good. Because you live in a world of confusion, in a world of duality. They even use it in your political realm. They use it in your religious realm. They use it in your psychological realm. Everybody's running around telling you what's good and what's evil. And we're all walking in a wall of confusion. We're walking in a wall of doubts. And all these ideologies are being run through us like a train. Because everybody's trying to figure out what in the world is good and what in the world is evil. Because you're walking in a world of confusion. And that's what the God of this world has done. You're walking around trying to figure out what's good and what's evil. And you're finding out it's all good and it's all evil. Yep. Because as long as you walk around in duality, everything's good and everything's evil. This is where a Gnostic perspective comes from. Because we know that there is a God of this universe, and we also know there's a God of this world. And whatever you want to call the God of this world, you want to call him the devil, you want to call him the demiurge, you want to call him Yaldabaoth, whatever you want to call him, he's still the God of this world. And instead of trying to figure out why, what you need to be figuring out is what you can do to get out of that system. And that's where the world, in its hostility, is fighting. If you've been noticing in the last few years, there's a war between what is good and what is evil. And it has been rising to an anticipation that's beyond our mind and our thinking and our comprehension. I mean, it has elevated itself beyond anything that you and I could ever know of, that we ever could live of. Now, this thing has really intensified. You've seen 5G spreading like wildfire. Chemtrails spreading like wildfire. This hideous disease that every time you turn on the news, that's all they're talking about. But see, we in the Gnostic community are seeing beyond the bullshit. We'll say, wait a minute. Your statistics are not lining up to what I see. I walk out of my apartment and I'm walking around in my community, and I'm walking around in a mall and in Walmart, I don't see people dropping like flies. But I go home and I turn on the news, they're telling me this many people a day is dying from this hideous disease. But I open my windows and I see something differently. It's because people are looking beyond the programming. So when you're seeking knowledge and wisdom and understanding beyond the stuff that's going on in this world, it's called being a Gnostic. Being a Gnostic is not people joining a religion. It's not people accepting certain dogmatic beliefs. Gnostics are just seeing beyond the bullshit. Some of us are waking up to the lies and the deceptions and saying, hey, y'all, wait a minute. I've got some questions. And now, everywhere you're asking these questions, they're telling you, stop asking those questions. But the questions are making more sense than what they are telling you. Because the question is saying, wake up, back up, back up, back up, brother, back up, sister, wait a minute. What you're telling me is not what I'm seeing. And they're saying, but put your mask on and stay 6 feet from each other. Just shut up. Don't talk to anybody about it. Just listen to what we have to say. We know better than you do. Just shut up. Go get poked with this shot. Go let us put something up your nose. You know, up your nose with a rubber hose. Now we know what it means. When they tell you up your nose with a rubber hose, just shut up. Listen to us. We know better than you. Stay in your little four corners of the wall. Stay in your bubbles. Don't come out. Don't question what you're seeing. Just listen to what we're saying. You remember, don't do as I do, but do as I say. Remember that? That's going all over the place. Don't tell me to wear a mask when you're not wearing a mask. Don't tell me to go get poked when you're not getting poked. Because people are waking up. And now people are seeing who the God really is. The God of this world has blinded the mind of the people. So who is God? It's whom you made into your image. You see, in the beginning, when the gods came down, they made mankind in their image. But now, mankind is taking God and making him into their image. Let me throw this out at you. If you're mean and hateful and ugly, your God is mean and hateful and ugly. You walk around in fear and doubt and confusion, your God is fear and doubt and confusion. If your God is full of love and mercy and forgiveness, then you are full of love, mercy, and forgiveness. But being a Gnostic in a hostile world is going to cause battles. It's going to cause wars. And in those battles and in those wars, there is casualty. But you've got to wake up. It's the only way to get out of all of this. You have got to wake up. And it's not going to be easy. I'm going to tell you right now, it's not going to be easy. But people all over are waking up. They know when something is going on. Something is not right. And they're seeking for knowledge and wisdom and understanding. And how are you going to find it? Where are you going to find it? Just seeking. Your Bible says to seek the Lord while he may be found. once you get beyond the bullshit, you will find the truth. Did not Christ say 2,000 years ago, ye shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free? We're going to talk about this more in future episodes so that you can look beyond the lies and the deception and find the truth. This little light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I said that I'm gonna let it shine. I said that this little light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. And each and every day, and in my life, to let the light shine. The hallelujah, 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 to let the light shine.